болтали там с этим родным, забытый ночь стоит. Какая тьма у вкуса ноги, пусть не совсем освоит. Скоро дружбу не тая, ее по плечу его я. И солнце тоже, и да я, и там товарищ двое. Пойдет поэт, горит, поет, у мира в сером хламе. Я буду солнце лить твое, а ты поешь стихами. И на сеней, ночей тюрьма, от солнца у солнца и мало. Эй, эта кутерьма блестит, во что попало. Станет пол и хочет ночь, велей тупая солнечка. Но во всю светаю пол, снова сей трезвонится. Светит всегда, светит везде, за дней последних солнца. Светит и не катит гвоздей, вот-вот он пол и пол.
As he himself said, the word, its outline, its phonetic side, determines the germinating of poetry on the one hand, but on the other, he wanted to maintain that the word was a necessary condition for the new art. The poetry of futurism is the poetry of the city, so said the futurists. The city enriches our experience and impressions of new elements of urban life, which poets of the past never knew. The city is changing. And in poetry itself, the essence of a new individual is being born, specifically city person. Telephones, express trains, lifts, aeroplanes, factories, chimneys, giant stone buildings, smoke and noise are the new elements of beauty and city nature. Electric streetlights are more often seen than the old romantic moons. Mayakovsky went on to say that the rhythm of life had changed, and that a smooth, relaxed, unhurried rhythm of poetry was no longer relevant to the psychology of the contemporary urban dweller. Poetry must include and get into the language the experience of this new type of person. The word must not describe, but express itself about itself. A word has its own aroma, color, soul. A word has a life of its own. It's a living organism. Words are themselves fit subjects for poetry or literature. They should not be used as representing ideas.